Hi, Tome Readers.
Hi, Tome Readers.
This is going to be our last prompt for the book group, and Matt and I decided instead of doing two separate monologues that we would do a conversation, do a dialogue together in one video.
Yeah, so basically what we're doing is we're bridging the gap, traversing across technology to come together and make a recording together. So here we are. And here we go.
So, I'm kind of curious, Matt, how you're feeling about Tome Readers, because this was kind of one of, it was your first experience with this book.
Mm-hmm.
You've never really been through this book before, but also we did a lot of social media stuff that wasn't completely new to you. You'd kind of dipped your toes in before, but I think you got a lot more involved with Tome Readers than you had with some of the other stuff you've done.
Well, I'll just go ahead and admit, first of all, that I did not use Twitter. I've had a Twitter account for probably as long as it's been around, but it never turned out to be one of the things that I adopted. Facebook I've used quite a bit. Every once in a while, I would try to get a group or two together. Matter of fact, one thing that I wanted to start, I was really excited about it, was when they did commission the space shuttles. So I started a Facebook group. It didn't take off, but it was Bring the Shuttles to Ohio.
No.
So one of the shuttles at least to Ohio. That failed. So this is actually the first successful group I've been a part of on Facebook. And of course, this was a brand new experience with Twitter. I understood Twitter to some extent, but there's a lot that comes with actually using Twitter that
yeah.
you don't realize. You think maybe it's a news feed. You think maybe it's just a stream of information. It turns out that from this experience, we found out that it's a whole lot more than that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I love Twitter, and I use Twitter pretty extensively for several years, but I didn't get it at first. It took me a while, and it took finding other people online,
mm-hmm.
finding a community that I could connect with to kind of make that apparent to me,
right.
and kind of make it something that I got, and it took a while for
yeah.
me to find that. So
ideas started popping up, especially working with the online community. A few people in particular who I'm sure we'll be mentioning here in a little while. The things, the ideas, the collaborations that happened while on Twitter, just the way that they transformed, the way that they started out as a simple idea, maybe a picture, a photograph, a few conversations, a sentence from the book, would often expand into these little experiments with technology, with education. So that was pretty exciting, but it also started leading to ideas.
Yeah.
And a lot of ideas on my own that I started talking to administrators and faculty about trying to implement, or eventually I will talk to more
right.
faculty. I've already talked to an administrator, but I need to talk to more faculty about some of these ideas, and I actually hope to implement them since the school year is quickly approaching here. Matter of fact,
yeah.
I have a session on the very first day, the 24th of August, and I'm going to run the idea by the professor, who's actually also an administrator and my boss. I already talked to him about it, and I actually want to try to see if it works. So
that's really exciting.
Yeah.
That's really cool stuff.
Yeah.
So Tome Readers has been really great for me in terms of helping me to expand my network and helping me to kind of digest this book in different ways,
mm-hmm.
Especially if you have a piece of something. If you have a book or an article or an online course that you're working through together, it's great to do it on campus, and that's what we've been doing in the past, is we've been having on campus conversations, but it's just been so exciting to open this thing up to the world and get feedback from people from all over the US and all over the world, because we had lots of so many cool people that participated in our Twitter chats or talked to us on Facebook, and helped us to kind of digest this book in different ways. And it's not over yet. I mean, Tome Readers has always been based on focal dates instead of due dates,
mm-hmm.
and our final focal date is coming up, but it's not like that's an end date. Just like the start date wasn't really a start date, the end date isn't really an end date. And I'm sure that it'll bleed over a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
So,
actually, speaking of feedback, you mentioned feedback a little while. This is also going to be our opportunity to use this video to solicit a little bit more feedback from our community as well. And so, Autumn, my question, since this was your idea, this is your baby to take this on here, is the question is, well, what is the next step in this process? What are we looking to do next? We want to ask our viewers, we want to ask our participants, our community out there for something a little specific. You said something, and we've talked about it a little bit, something about the Rhizomatic experience. I wonder if you can tell us a little bit more about what to expect and what we're going to be looking forward to here coming up.
So, Tome Raiders was kind of an offshoot of my experience as a participant in Rhizo 15. And the whole idea of Rhizomatic learning is that the community is the curriculum. The community is what's building everything. And in Tome Raiders, I think Tome Raiders definitely kind of is a hybrid of a Rhizomatic approach because we had a piece of content. We had a specific piece of content that the community did not decide on. I decided on that. You and I both decided on that, actually. And we had, you know, kind of vetted that here with our community on campus. But when we opened it up to the world, you guys out there, you had no idea, and you just kind of came along for the ride with the book that we chose. So in that respect, I think that is not Rhizomatic, because the community did not create that.
Mm-hmm.
But the whole idea of Rhizomatic learning is that the community is the curriculum, and it's a very interesting way to think about learning, to think about thinking. It's based on these two French philosophers, Deleuze and Guattari, who wrote this book called A Thousand Plateaus, and one of the first metaphors that they talk about is the rhizome, and thinking about learning as a rhizomatic principle. So, you know, not something that's linear, but something that branches off and connects back to different nodes.
Well, just to ask a little bit about this, the idea of the rhizome. So rhizome, as I understand it, is a series of interconnected roots.
Yeah, botanically. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And is the metaphor following that?
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
Exactly. So, you know, rhizomes are difficult to kill, and they have a tendency to be somewhat invasive. All of these are like the different metaphors that we played with in Rhizo 15. And so I don't want to get too much into what the rhizome is right now.
Sure.
I think that if you're interested in that, there's some information out there. Check out Dave Cormier, because check out his blog and some of the stuff that he's published. There's tons of that kind of stuff. And I really hope that we're going to do a Rhizo 16 next year. So participate in that MOOC. And, but I guess the only thing that you need to know, and the people out there in the world need to know, is that that was kind of my impetus. That was like my inspiration to say, hey, let's open up the book group to everybody in the world and see if other people will play with us. And believe it or not, people did, which was really exciting for me. As we go forward, though, when we think about reflecting upon this, I'd like to try to get back to those rhizomatic roots and open up the evaluation to the community. So here's my idea, is that I'd like to start a Google document, and you and I talked about this, and we're going to have three different parts. We're going to have a demographic section. We're going to have a challenges section. So anything within the book group that was challenging for you, or you found like kind of difficult to deal with, and then a benefits section to thinking about digesting a piece of content in that way. I hesitate to use that word, but yes, that's what I'm thinking of this book as. I'm thinking of it as a piece of content. So, and then just kind of use that as a structure in a Google document, but invite you, the community, to come and contribute questions, and then ultimately take that survey as well. So that's kind of the idea. It's kind of an experiment. I hope that it works. If people don't really contribute, I've got some ideas of how we'd want to take the survey ultimately as well. Also, and again, you know this, but I don't know if the folks out there in the world know this. So Matt and I have submitted a proposal to do a poster presentation at an AACNU conference. And if that gets accepted, then we'd like to report on the evaluation. That'll be a part of the poster presentation. And if it doesn't get accepted there, then we'll, you know, submit it someplace else, or, you know, just kind of put it out there on the web for the world at large, and we'll publish it ourselves. So, so yeah, that's kind of like what I want to do with the feedback from everybody, and also use it to inform our own, world in terms of doing anything like this in the future.
So, I guess the call is basically going out right here first time for you to give us the questions that you would like answered, like to see answered. So we need help building the survey. We'd like you to participate. Talk about, form your challenges and put your challenges in the form of a question. Give them to us on our Google document. We'll put the web address out there for everybody to look at. And this will help contribute to the whole resumetic principle here of using community to basically poll the community. So I think that's about it.
There's going to have to be a deadline too.
We're going to have to
cut that off. So I'm thinking maybe a week, maybe 2 weeks. I guess we can talk about that offline and we'll publish that along with the video. I'm sorry that this video is so long. It's a little longer than I think we were going to be, but I don't want to re-record it because I think that that's going to, I don't know, like take away from some of the spontaneity.
Just sit down and be entertained. How about that? Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
All right. We'll tell people to get some popcorn before they watch this video. Thank you everyone for watching this video and for playing with us on the internet as we read this book together. So that was awesome. Thank you.
Yeah. And I'll see you out there and online.
Bye.